So the Philadelphia 76ers were pretty revolutionary in the mid-2010s when they had themselves go with the process. What is going on, everybody? How is everybody doing today? Yeah, we are going to be doing a Trust the Process rebuild with the Philadelphia 76ers. So this is going to be a 2015-16 start. So we do not have Ben Simmons. We do have guys like Embiid, Rocco, Sarge, those guys on the team. Rashawn Holmes is still here, etc. But yeah, this is going to be another historic rebuild. I did do a Kristaps Porzingis Knicks rebuild about a week and a half ago before the trade deadline. If you guys enjoy these historic rebuilds, let's see if this video can get 2,000 likes. Because I'm definitely down to do more on the channel. And I'm kind of itching towards maybe doing a franchise historic series. I don't know. That's something that might happen. But yeah, this is going to be the 2015-16 season. And this will be with the draft class of guys like Ben Simmons, Brandon Ingram, Malcolm Brogdon, Jaylen Brown. And we'll see who we can possibly add to this team. Jamal Murray as well. Obviously, we have a bunch of centers with Nerlens Noel, Joel Embiid, Jahlil Okafor. Unfortunately, the contracts aren't exactly the same, I believe. Like, unless we have a team option. Yeah, so like Noel and Okafor will be free agents at the end of the year. So maybe I should just trade them now and get picks like Sam Hinkie would have done. So yeah, this is pretty much what we're working with at the moment. And we can look to trade them because obviously we want to play Embiid, and Embiid's contract isn't up to date where it should have been. But like, who could we pick up? Monta Ellis. He's 29. I don't think I really want Monta. And then Serge Ibaka, he's got 2 years on his contract. I mean, I wouldn't mind Serge on this team. I wouldn't. And Steven Adams, who would Steven Adams be a free agent? No, he's got a team option. All right, you know what? We're going to trade these two centers for these two centers. And Serge is 25. I feel like he would be a little bit older, but I could be wrong. So yeah, we're trading Nerlens Noel and Jahlil Okafor for Ibaka and Adams. Could I maybe get a first-round pick out of this, OKC? And they will not. They would want Jeremy Grant. It's funny. You'll give me two first-round picks. We'll give you Jeremy Grant. Because Jeremy Grant and Rashawn Holmes were on the process teams, and they, like, Holmes turned out to be a very good center in the NBA. And then Grant turned out to be possibly the most improved player in the NBA. So yeah, let's see what the starting five will look like. It'll be McConnell, Trey Sims, Rocco, Sarge, Embiid, with the bench of Ibaka, Adams, Deion Adrian. I want to play Rashawn Holmes. And then is there anybody not playing? Yeah, we can play like Jakar Sampson over Adrian. Why not? And then, we'll simulate till the end of the year. Our coach at this time was probably Brett Brown. I don't know if you could sign Brett Brown in free agency, in coaching free agency, but we'll see. And we'll try to do that at the end of the year. And I'll see you guys at the end of the 2015-16 season. So at the end of the season, we end up with a lot better of a record than I thought. We were the 11th seed. That's not tanking. Come on. So James Harden's your MVP. We get rookie of the year Trey Sims. I'm pretty sure that is not a real player. Serge Ibaka, sixth man of the year, boom, up in that trade value. Anthony Davis, defensive player of the year for the Pels. Rondae Hollis Jefferson, most improved for Brooklyn. And Steven Silas, which at the time would have been Mike D'Antoni, gets coach of the year. Here's All-NBA first team: Harden, Lillard, James, Davis, and Cousins. Missing Cousins on the All-NBA team. Second team, you got Curry, Westbrook, Durant, Giannis, and Vucevic. Third team, you got Drummond, Draymond. Okay, yeah, Draymond putting up good numbers. Jimmy, Wall, and Kyrie. Here's all defensive first team: Dwayne Wade on it. You got George, AD, Giannis, and Drummond. And second team, you got Paul, Allen, Leonard, James, and Hibbert. So is it like the right rookie teams? It would have been like Towns, Porzingis. No, it's Filler is on this. Okay. So we do take a look at our stats. I'll probably release Trey Sims. I don't feel like he should play. I don't even know why he started. Yeah, I don't even know. But yeah, Embiid, 18 and 8.5 in his, like, this would be his first real year. Ibaka was great for us. But yeah, this team still isn't good. I don't know how we were only the 11th seed. Why weren't we any bit worse? We ended up going 20, we won 29 games, but then four other teams were worse than us. All right, oh my God. So we are going to have like the 9th pick. We could definitely be able to trade up though in the draft. And it is a Cavs-Rockets finals, LeBron versus Harden, and LeBron, Kyrie Irving, and K-Love, they end up winning the finals in 7 games. So Duncan, Ginobili, and Dante Jones retiring. Duncan goes to the Hall of Fame. I feel like Ginobili would eventually end up going. So we need to replace some of these. We got to go back to the 2018 lottery system. Actually, that's pretty much it. Yeah, so we are going to do that. And draft lottery time, which means we are probably not going to move up in the draft. We have a 4.3% chance we are going to have pick 7 most likely. And oh my God, we go up to 2! Let's go! Let's freaking go! We get lucky! Trust the process, baby! And we go up to 2. Yes, let's go. So the Pelicans get 1. They could bring Ben Simmons to Anthony Davis. We are going to fire Doc Rivers. Let me actually just view and see if Brett Brown is here. And it's looking like Brett Brown is, nope, there's a Mike Brown, a Tony Brown, a Jaden Brown, a Samuel Brown, an Eric Brown, but no Brett Brown is on the game anymore. Because like, I feel like Doc Rivers in 2015 would not have came over from the Clippers to be the coach. Like, we could still have Sam Cassell and Dave Joerger as our assistants, but like our head coach, who would have been a head coach for the process? I feel like Lionel Hollins would have been a head coach for the process. So we end up signing Lionel Hollins to be our head coach. We get these scouts and trainers, and yeah, let's go here to the NBA draft where we now have pick two. I don't know if like who's the consensus number one. Like, I have no idea who they're going to take. It's looking like it will be Ben Simmons. So are we going to add a Brandon Ingram, a Chris Dunn, a Malcolm Brogdon? Who knows? Do I make a trade as well? Do I trade potentially Serge Ibaka? Or do I try to trade Serge Ibaka in 28 and 37 for another top 10 pick? Ooh, could do that with the Knicks. Yeah, let's do this. I don't really want Robin Lopez, but we can always flip Robin Lopez. So we're going to do Ibaka first, 28, 37, and a future second for pick 7. So we're going to add another top rookie. Let's see who the Pelicans take number one. And then I think I'm either going to take Ingram or Simmons. So if they go Simmons, I'll probably go Brandon Ingram here at 2. I mean, we could definitely go Jaylen Brown, but I think I like Brandon Ingram on this team. So yeah, we are going to pick up Brandon Ingram, and we'll see who's there at 7 for us. So the remaining picks, I saw Buddy Hield there. So it ended up going Chris Dunn, Brogdon, Sabonis, and then NBA front court would have been fun. And Jaylen Brown, oh, he just goes. He would have been nice. So I think I'm going to land Jamal Murray here. And we're going to have a Jamal Murray, Brandon Ingram, and Embiid trio court. And then we can fill in like Sarge and Rocco in between. I like that. So yeah, Simmons is an 83, an absolute stud. Rookie signing. Yep, welcome to the team, Brandon Ingram and Jamal Murray. Wonder where Pascal Siakam went. Steven Adams picking up his team option. Free agency doesn't look like it's going to be great. We're going to give Sarge the qualifying offer. And yeah, so going into free agency, how many players do we have under contract that I want to play? About 3. I mean, yeah, I want to trade Rolo because we already have Holmes and Adams. I don't need another center. I mean, like, what could I... Could I move Adams and Rolo for, like, a good wing? I mean, Michael could go, Chris. He's 21. He would not be 21 at this time. He'd be, like, 23, 24. But we are going to get these first-round picks from the Pelicans. We were sending Adams and Pelicans just a couple years early. And, yeah, those picks could be good next year when it's going to be the 2017 class, which is pretty good. It's Kyle Kuzma's class. Now you got, like, Isaac, Mitchell, Tatum. And, yeah, we already had Holmes as the backup center. So, at the moment, we have 6 guys. And if I bring back Sarge, that will be 7. And I would like to bring back Sarge, so he doesn't want to re-sign with us. But we have, like, a max slot. Now, I don't think I'm going to sign a max guy now, even though there's some solid free agents, but it's not really anything too special. So I'd like to go after another shooter. Bradley Beal. Oh, my God, he would fit the process so well. Kobe! No, I'm not going to go for Kobe. Bradley Beal would fit this process really well. Give us a good shooter. But, like, I don't know. I don't think I'm going to go after Bradley Beal. I think we're going to go after, like, Evan Fortin, now he wants 19 mil, damn. I mean, Bradley Beal does have 0 offers. So, you know what, screw it. We're going to sign Bradley Beal. Do we end up getting him? Yes, we do. We are not going to renounce the rights on Dario Saric. I will match any deal he gets. And is it going to auto make me do it? Wait, where's Dario? Okay, yeah, no, it's not. Okay, good. So, yeah, we signed Bradley Beal. That's huge. We are going to eventually sign Dario Saric. And we're going to look for another wing in, I mean, like Harrison Barnes, Nicholas Batum. I would not mind Harrison Barnes coming off the bench for us. But no, then we wouldn't be able to bring back, what's his name, Dario Saric. So I'm going to look to bring in, Jeff Green on a one-year deal. Yeah, we could bring Jeff Green in on a one-year deal. He'll be the 9th man in the rotation. I will renounce the rights on Jakar Sampson. Come on, Jeff Green. Oh, he signs with the Clippers. Are you kidding me? Really? So we're going to sign Richard Jefferson on a one-year deal. The vet. Yep, we get the vet. And then let's go in and let's sign Dario Saric. So Saric, 3-year, 13 mil a year. A little bit of an overpay, definitely. But you know what? I want to bring him back. He's part of the process. Okafor, how did he do last year? 11-6 for OKC. I mean, he was playing with KD, Russ, and those guys. And there was Nerlens Noel. So player progression, we got Bradley Beal. I think perfect part of the process. I mean, like, Jamal Murray, Bradley Beal, and Brandon Ingram. Yeah, Ben Simmons probably would have fit this team a little bit more, having kind of that distributor. Because Jamal Murray, not the greatest passer and just facilitator in the world. Obviously, he's kind of more of a shot first guard. So maybe down the line, we're going to have to eventually add, like, something like a Chris Paul. Like, but we just signed Bradley Beal, so I don't even know if that's possible. I'm hoping this is a good 2017 class. I mean, they're not great on Xbox Series X this year. I would have to say, like, compared to PC, like, they're really good on PC. So Ingram, you're getting on top potential. Joel Embiid and Bradley Beal, you guys are also getting on top potential, all up to 8+. Very nice. So here is the starting 5. Jamal Murray, Bradley Beal, Brandon Ingram, Dario Saric, and Joel Embiid with a front, or a bench, why did I say front court, of Rocco, TJ, Rashawn Holmes, and Richard Jefferson, the vet. System proficiency for Lionel Hollins is 3-star pace and space, but we will be going not to triangle. Triangle is actually the highest. screw it, we're going to Triangle. 20th in power rankings, we'll see if we make the playoffs this year. Not off to a great start, though. All right, the process did not work out how we wanted to this year. We ended up as the 10th seed in the Eastern Conference. Only one seed better. We added Brandon Ingram, Bradley Beal, and Jamal Murray. Yes, we did lose Steven Adams and Serge Ibaka, but come on. James Harden, your MVP. Ben Simmons, rookie of the year, so it's not Brandon Ingram. Was he close, Ingram and Murray? They were solid. They were. I mean, Ingram was pretty efficient for a rookie, and Murray was also pretty efficient for a rookie. Like, not super efficient overall, but solid for a rookie. D'Lo, okay. He's a stud out there in LA. And the Rockets went 74-8. Did they add anybody new to their team? Or is it still just Dwight and Harden? I mean, I'll have to take a look. Did they add Kevin Durant? No, he goes to the Clippers. Kevin Love joined LeBron and Kyrie, making all NBA teams. Damn, okay. We do get Murray and Ingram on all-rookie first team. But yeah, this Rockets team went 74-8. Beverly, Harden, Ariza, Horford, and Drummond is their front court now. Okay. They got Capella, Brewer, Harrell, Skylar Bissier, and Tim Frazier off the bench. And once again, we did not make the playoffs. What did we go? 38-46? 36-46. And we ended up as the 10th seed in the Eastern Conference. Not great. We missed out on the playoffs by two spots. Taking a look at the stats. I don't know. Do I move Bradley Beal? No. Bradley Beal was great for us. I don't want to move Embiid. I don't. Maybe I got to increase his shot tendency, but his efficiency has been horrible. What's going on with Embiid? There's Murray, Ingram, Sarge, McConnell, Holmes. Okay, yeah, I probably need to upgrade this bench too. What's his shot tendency? He was at a 99. Oh, this isn't good. So let's see who wins the 2017 NBA Finals. That was what the Warriors in real life. The Rockets win it this time. They lost to the Cavs last year. They beat the Raptors in 5. And this Raptors team did not even have DeRozan. What? How did they make it to the finals? Okay, so we'll have a couple guys making the Hall of Fame in Vince Carter, Kevin Garnett, and Paul Pierce. Speaking of Paul Pierce, he has been wilding on Instagram. He's probably gonna get fired from ESPN. Or he's gonna get suspended, probably, if you know what I'm talking about. If he wasn't already, because I'm recording this on Saturday because I'm going home for Easter, and then I'll be, you guys are probably seeing this on Tuesday. So we have the 10th pick projected. Do we get lucky? No, we do not. We actually dropped to 11, so a team below us got really lucky. And we also have 23rd via the Pelicans. Damn, so I was hoping that pick would be a little bit better. We're gonna sign Mike D'Antoni to be our second assistant coach, because why not? Or let's pick up Dylan Thorpe as our... Okay! Does anybody want to be my CFO? Thank you. They're just looking at what could I get for Embiid. I think I'm doing this trade right here. Okay, what even is that offer? Yeah, I mean, like, Vucevic has been better, but no, I gotta keep Embiid. He's like the heart and soul of the process. Even though Simmons, also big heart and soul, but we didn't get him because this video was a little bit before he ended up on the team. So we have the 11th and 23rd pick. I wonder if I could trade, let's see. Can we trade 11, 23, and 41 to move up to 5 with the Heat? No, but I will give you that Pelicans pick in 2023. Boom, we have pick 5. I'm hoping one of the studs fall to me there. But I mean, in this class, could it be Isaac? Probably not. Could it be? It's definitely not gonna be Mitchell or Tatum. Fultz goes 1. Okay. I mean, Lonzo we could use as well. I mean, there goes Mitchell. He goes to the Knicks. That's pretty cool. I think he's from Connecticut. He's a Mets fan. The Kings are at 3. They're probably going to take Tatum, right? Yeah, they take Tatum. And then this Nets at 4. They get to keep their pick. I put it on where every team gets to keep their pick. So lucky Nets for this video. Oh, Fox would have been nice. I forgot about Fox completely. All right, so Jonathan Isaac's on the board. John Collins is on the board. Lonzo Ball's on the board. Who's like the highest ranked guy? Okay, Dylan Brooks. Lonzo's rated 14th. All right, I guess I'm going to take Jonathan Isaac here. He's going to be, I guess, a good bench player for us. Maybe he'll start at the 4. Yeah, so Isaac's a 77 overall, same as Tatum. So you know what? I will take that. We are going to be signing him. Team player options, we got nobody there. There's some good free agents. Oh, I should have waited. Chris Paul would have been nice. I don't think we're going to have nearly any money to get Chris Paul. I mean, let's see. Like, what does Chris Paul want a year? 40 mil? We would have to clear up $25 million, which means we'd have to move Embiid or Beal. I mean, we could move Sarge and Ingram and Isaac, but why would I want to do that? So, like, potential point guards, I would like to bring back TJ. Yeah, I'll bring back TJ. Any other guys we have on bird rights? Rocco, I can bring back. We can always trade him. Holmes, same thing. And do we get all three of those guys? I think we do. And yes, we do. So, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 guys. I think I'm just going to keep the team how it is. We have everybody pretty much locked up long-term now. Yeah, like the only free agent next year is nobody. Everybody has a team option, so we're good there. Let's see where some of the big guys sign. LeBron goes to the Celtics. Blake Griffin goes to the Nuggets. Let's see where Giannis and Curry. Curry goes to the Knicks. Knicks get Curry and Donovan Mitchell as their backcourt. And Giannis goes to the Nets. Player progression, we got Beal up to a 90, Embiid up to an 86, Ingram 85, Murray 80, and then there's Sarge, Isaac, Rocco, McConnell, and Holmes. Taking a look at, or we can just go straight to training camps now. Everybody went up. Obviously, we're still a very young team. I think we lack a little bit of defense, but I'm hoping Jonathan Isaac helps us out a lot with that. We do have three training camps, and whoever's not an A-plus on top potential, we'll be sending them there. So Ingram, we'll be sending Jamal Murray, our starting point guard, and then we will also be sending Jonathan Isaac, who I believe is not A-plus, and he wasn't. So it's going to be Murray, Beal, Ingram, Isaac, and Embiid with a bench of Sarge, Rocco, McConnell, and Holmes. Let's hope that this team can make the playoffs. I mean, this team should make the playoffs. We're not going triangle. We're going to balance. And yeah, let's hope this team can make the playoffs in 2018. There we go. At the end of the 2017-18 season, the process finally makes the playoffs as the 4th seed. James Harden wins MVP once again. Fox, Rookie of the Year for the Nets. Fox and Giannis there. Ty Lawson, Sixth Man of the Year. He's still in the NBA. You got AD, Defensive Player of the Year. Malcolm Brogdon, Most Improved for Boston. And then Stephen Silas, Coach of the Year once again. Yeah, that Rockets team is very, very good. Wow, Yusuf Nurkic emerged as the Denver Nuggets center because they had Nurkic and Jokic at the same point, and they chose Jokic, rightfully so. And yeah, they stuck with Nurkic here, and I kind of want to see where Jokic is at. Is he a trade candidate possibly in the offseason? Is he going for the cheap? Is he going for the low? We have to find out. Jonathan Isaac, All-NBA first team. You love to see it. I don't know why I said All-NBA first team. I meant All-Rookie first team. You know what I meant. So, yeah, we ended up making the playoffs. We're taking on the five-seeded Bulls. The Nuggets did not make the playoffs. I'm very intrigued now to see where Jokic is at in this point of his career. So he is not in... Okay, he's actually on the Pacers. Damn, did they trade for him? Oh, they actually signed him. How much did they sign him for? Was it cheap? No, it was not. But yeah, we're taking on the Bulls in round one. They will have Jimmy Butler still. They have Derrick Rose, who's a 90 overall, and he's still really good. TLC, Jimmy Butler, yep. Pau Gasol is there as well. He's the 91 overall. Okay, Tristan Thompson. They have Bobby Portis still. Doug McDermott as well. Garrett Temple. And Filler's Filler. So Beal led us in scoring, followed by Ingram and Embiid. Embiid's efficiency, man, has not been very good. Maybe I got a lower shot three tendency, and that could help. Ingram, 17 points, 5 rebounds, 4 assists. He was very efficient for us this season. Beal was an absolute stud. And then we got Jamal Murray averaging 17, 4, and 6, 40, 37, 97 splits. And then there's Isaac, Sarge, Rocco, and McConnell and Holmes. So I do want to see Embiid's shot three tendency. And is it like at a 90 or something where I got to low it? It's at... what is it at? It's, where is his shot three tendency? It's at a 52. We'll lower that. I don't know why I spot up three tendencies at an 86. We'll lower that as well. And I think we should be good to go. So can we beat the Bulls and get our first playoff series victory in our first time making the playoffs in this video? Ingram dropping 28, Murray 25, Beal 21 and 11. Rocco drops 20. Okay. The man that's not efficient at all, really. He was better this year, but he plays well. Okay. Okay. Embiid, not great. Not great. On to game two. We pick up the victory. Let's go by 1 point. Ingram, 23. Beal, 13 and 13. Embiid, 3 for 11. All right. Game three. Okay, we take a 3-0 victory lead. And we, Embiid, better, 19 and 19, 9 for 14 shooting. Beal drops 25. Ingram, 30. He's blossoming into a star in these playoffs. And can we sweep them and go on to round two? Yes, we can. We beat them by 6 points in an absolute shootout as Beal, 35 and 8. Ingram 30, Embiid 21-9-5, McConnell even had 13 assists, and we're on to round two to take on the one-seeded Raptors, the reigning Eastern Conference champion. So the Raptors have Kyle Lowry, Norman Powell, Damari Carroll, Myers Leonard. Carroll's an 85? Damn, shout out to Damari Carroll. Valanciunas, Plumlee, Joseph. I mean, that's not that good of a team. It's not. We should be able to beat them. We are better on paper. Let's go! We're so much better than this team. We end up winning by 25. Just kidding, that's 15. Embiid, yes, prove me wrong. Stop. You know what? He's got to stop taking threes. He just can't hit them. In the playoffs, he's shooting 18% from three. Yeah, his shot three tendency is going down to like 5. Yeah, we're putting it at 5, and it better stay that way. So on to game two, we win. Lowry drops 31, was not enough. Embiid, yeah, it's better when he's not taking the threes. 22 and 12, Murray with 25. What is he doing in the playoffs? He's been playing well. Oh my God, he has yet to miss a free throw. Knock on wood. Wow, he's actually been perfect in every single attempt. Wow. All right, can we go up 3-0? No, we cannot. All right, our first playoff L. Embiid dropped 20 and 9. Beal 23. Murray didn't miss a free throw. Valanciunas had 29-11. Embiid, do not let Valanciunas beat us as they tie it up 2-2. God damn it. We end up losing by 25. Ugh, this was an ugly game. Ugly game. Jamal Murray still hasn't missed a free throw. Shout out to him. Beal, he's missed some free throws. All right, don't lose game 5. Okay, there we go. We're up 3-2. We win by 7 on the road. Beal drops 40 and 9. Ingram with 23. Embiid with 18 and 15. Murray, Didn't miss a free throw. All right, game six. Can we win in six? No, we're going to a game seven. We lost by four. And Murray missed the free throw. No, no. Okay, game seven. It's going to be in Toronto, too. This is going to... Oh, my God. Oh, no. I want to cry. What is going on? All right, we came back. Come on. All right, down by two. 5 minutes and 11 seconds left in the third. Can we come back? Please, process. Make it close. All right, tie game. All right, we're down by two, a minute and 16. Let's win this game. We're in Toronto. We'll make sure we're on Hall of Fame. We don't have the ball, which is actually really rough that we don't have the ball because that would be huge since we're down by two. Oh, we need a defensive stop. And like Murray, B perimeter D, not great. We got Ingram out there. Beal's also out there. And B, or no, we got Holmes and Isaac. Isaac's got 25 and 5. Lowry for three. Please, no, let's go. Rebound by Beal. Up to Jamal Murray. Over to Ingram. Ingram from downtown. Come on. Way downtown. Brandon Ingram gives us the lead. B.I., the second overall pick in the 2016 draft, coming up clutch for us, and we have the lead. I feel like they're just going to try to go with Kyle Lowry like every single possession. Isaac, stay here. Let's go. Isaac, great contest. And Jamal Murray somehow gets that rebound. Let's go. Over to Brett. Oh, no. No. I was like seeing if that's going to happen. I was like, no way that's going to be a backcourt. I'm so dumb. No, and Embiid fouled out as well. Sheesh. All right, we need another stop. Norman Powell for three. Terrible look. Come on, let's get the rebound. Thank you, Ingram. Let's go for the 2-for-1 because I want to get the final shot. Ingram, no, kick that to Isaac. Isaac inside. That should be good. I love that animation. And we are up by three, and we're going to get the final shot if they were to tie it. Jonathan Isaac, player of the game. Yeah, this man has 27 points. Killing it. The rookie, man. He's really killing it. You love to see it from J.I. And we got J.I., we got B.I., and that's pretty much it with the I's. Oh, no. What am I doing? Okay, Lowry driving. I don't know. Oh, my God. I love you, Jonathan Isaac. Kick it to Isaac. Isaac with the dunk, and that is it. And we're going to be going to the conference finals, upsetting the one-seeded Raptors. That's what you get. Let's go. I didn't even realize they had Myers Leonard on their team. But yeah, win by five. Carroll's going to have to shoot. Another terrible look. And we are going to be going to the conference finals. I actually really love this team. Like, this team is so much fun to play with. Even when we don't have Embiid out there. And now we got the Cavs. Oh, okay. Wait, they don't have LeBron. I forgot he went to Boston. Okay, so it's Irving. They got Gordon Hayward and Kevin Love. Obviously, I'd rather face them if they have Gordon Hayward than LeBron. So let's see how the series goes. Game one, we win. Let's go by 14. Kyrie dropped 49. Yeah, he's going to kill us. He's going to kill us in the series. Murray not missing a free throw. Embiid has a great game. Beal has a great game. Sarge has a great game. Ingram has a great game. Isaac has a good game. And we are up 1-0. Come on, go up 2-0. Damn. Ah, they blow us out. Kyrie drops 53. He's going to average 40 plus in the series. I know it. I know he's going to. Please win game three. Oh, we lose by 20. Don't go down 3-1. Please don't go down 3-1. Are you kidding me? Oh my God, we beat the one seed for nothing. We beat the one seed literally for nothing. Can we at least make it a 3-2 series? Nope, F me. We lose in the conference finals. God damn it. And the Cavs are in the finals once again, taking on the Phoenix Suns. They got Knight, Booker, Warren, Henry, L. Oh, how is this team in the finals? But we can't make it. Our team is so good on paper. Kyrie is so freaking good, man. He really is. He averaged 37 and 9 throughout those playoffs on 50-40-90 splits. So you got Dirk going to the Hall of Fame at the end of his career with the Atlanta Hawks of all teams. So this is the 2018 draft. Obviously, it was a loaded draft class with Luka, Shai, Jaren Jackson Jr. You got Marvin Bagley, but DeAndre Ayton, Trae Young, and LiAngelo Ball, Michael Porter Jr. Okay, LiAngelo Ball's in this class. I don't know if I'm going to make a trade at all. I kind of want to just run this team back, and I think this team could win the championship. I really do. You got to trust the process, man. You got to. So Ingram and Murray are picking up their options. Harden's a free agent. Oh, I would love Harden on this team over Beal. I really would, but I'm not going to do that. Is he going to go back to the Rockets? He's getting offered. Big Texas guy, you know? Big Texas guy. Melo is here. How's Melo been doing for the Knicks? He has been pretty good. He's been very efficient for them. So yeah, we really have no free agents. We're running the team back turbo, and let's hope that we can win the championship next year. So like the play regression, like we gotta like at least go to the finals next year, right? Like this team is so good. I can't believe we were only the 4 seed. Everybody progressing. I don't know why Embiid is not playing like Embiid that you would like for him to play like, but it is what it is. We gotta download the 2019 class now. We are gonna be sending everybody that's not A+ to Untapped Potential. Isaac didn't go up to an A+. Tell me Murray will go up to an A+. No, Ingram, will you go up to an A+? And he does. Hey, at least we got one guy up to an A+. So we are going to be entering, what is this, our third or fourth year now? Our third year? No, this would be our fourth year now. So here is the starting five. Murray, Beal, Ingram, Isaac, and Bede with the bench of Sarge, Rocco, McConnell, and Holmes. This team needs to go to the conference finals minimum next year. All right, I know we're only the 3 seed, but I have a feeling this is our year. Luka's on the Denver Nuggets. Not Jokic, he's there with Nurkic. Zach LaVine's on the Spurs. Giannis winning Defensive Player of the Year for the Nets. And Lonzo, most improved, he was drafted by the Utah Jazz. Jimmy Bickerstaff, I believe, of the Cavs, your coach of the year. So yeah, that's the team we gotta go through. It's not like we have to get through LeBron. It's Kyrie Irving that is so freaking good. Is he gonna own us? You know, I am so confident we are winning it all. This is the final year. I am so confident we are going to be winning it all. And this team is too good not to win it all. We have such good shooting in Murray, Beal, and Ingram. Good defense in the front court in Isaac and Embiid. We're getting about, 12? Yeah, we're getting 12 and a half assists out of our backcourt a game. Like, this team is good. Like, there is no reason we should not be making it to the conference finals. Minimum. And we're on the other side of the bracket than the Nets, or the side than the Nets, which is nice. So that's something we don't have to worry about. And here are the numbers if you were curious to see kind of what they look like. Embiid not taking a lot of threes anymore. Boom, 53% from the field. That's what I want to see. Taking on the team that we beat in the conference semifinals, the Toronto Raptors. They have Danilo Gallinari now. They also have Gary Harris. They have Valanciunas, Jared Dudley, Norman Powell. We should be able to beat them. Let's simulate the round. Come on. Let's go. We went at 5. Needed that. And we don't have to face the 2 seed. We're taking on the 7 seeded Pistons because they did the hard work for us. Yes, they have some centers that can shoot in Dwight Howard and Hassan Whiteside, but that is no match for us as we win in 5. And boom, we were on a collision course with Cleveland anyway. And it's time to get revenge for them beating us last year. It really is. They have Clint Capella now. I mean, good pickup. They don't have a good bench. Kyrie's not going to single-handedly beat us. We're up 2-0. Boom. Let's go. I told you. We end up having a better series against the best team in the NBA than we did against the 7th and 6th seeds. Let's go. Let's freaking go. I was so confident we're winning it all. And boom. Let's go. We win in 7. Yes. Yes, let's freaking go. Beal is your finals MVP. How did it go? We were down 1-0. We were down 2-0. 2-1. 2-2. We were down 3-2. Come back. We win game 6. And game 7, we win by 22 points. That's what I'm talking about. That's how it's done. You trust the process. Now I'm feeling though, it is pretty cool to win it in the final year. But yeah, thank you all for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. Drop a like if you did. Let me know in the comments any other historic rebuilds you guys like to see next. I might move them over to PC on 2K21 there because the rosters are probably a lot better over there and the draft classes as well. But yeah, that is going to be for me. Thank you all for watching. I love you guys. I'll catch y'all on the next one. Peace.